Now let's talk about question number three. Question number three says that you have a U-tube manometer, which is of a differential type. So you have oil of specific gravity 0.9 in the left limb, and then you have mercury in between the oil and the water, which is in the right limb. Okay, the dimensions are given to you, and it is also given to us that the absolute pressure at point B is 9.81 newtons per centimeter square. We have to find out the absolute pressure at point A. Okay, let's start with the question. It's a very simple one. Again, you have to equate the pressures on the two sides with respect to the datum. So let's find out, first of all, the pressure on the right hand side. Okay. So the pressure at point B is given to me as 9.81 newtons per centimeter square. So this is in CGS units. I need to convert this into SI, into Pascal. So this will be 98100 Pascal. So you multiply this by 10 to the power 4. Okay. So you will get P right. This is equal to, yes, you need to write down PB plus the pressure due to this liquid column of height 0.6, which is of water. You will get 1000 into 9.81 into 0.6. Okay, so PB is already known to us. So it is 98,100 plus this would be around 5800. To be exact, 5886. So when you add these two, you get a value in the right limb in Pascals, which will be 103,986 Pascals. So this is the pressure in the right limb. This pressure has to be equal to the pressure in the left limb. So let's find that out. So pressure in the left limb is equal to PA plus the pressure due to this much height of oil. You will have 0.2, the density will be 900 into 9.81 into 0.2 plus the 0.1 meter height of mercury column, and the density will be 13,600 into 9.81 into 0.1. Okay, so when you solve that, you get PA plus 13341.6 plus 1765.8. So that is the total pressure on the left hand side. So now you will have to equate this part and this part to get the value for PA. So when you do that, you write down PA plus 13341.6 plus 1765.8 equal to 103986. Okay, so from here I can easily find out PA, and that will be in Pascals. So PA would come about to be 888.76.8 newtons per meter square. So this is a fairly large value to write down every time. So let's convert it into CGS units. I will divide this by 10,000, okay, or 10 to the power 4. So 888.76.8 divided by 10 to the power 4, that would give you newtons per centimeter square, and this will be equal to 8.87 newtons per centimeter square. So that is the absolute pressure at point A. Okay, again a very simple question. Always remember, look at the dimensions given to you, recognize the liquids, and then simply find out the pressure in the right limb, the pressure in the left limb, and equate them to find out the given value. So I hope you understood this. Now let's move on to question number 4.